it's interesting because even in the education space, one of the things that I've seen when it comes to being agile is an old problem. And that was, you had a lot of students around the country, depending on where you lived, didn't have access to computers, didn't have access to a tablet, didn't have access to Wi-Fi. And most schools around the country who live in areas where it's low income or it's communities who don't have that access, they knew it, but it was exacerbated when COVID happened. So now they were faced with this issue that they absolutely had to address. It's like, okay, how do we switch to online learning? How can we pivot to this and become somewhat agile when we know that there's a part of our population that doesn't have a computer, doesn't have a tablet, and can't access lessons?
You know, we're talking about an old problem, and what we're really talking about is inequity, right?
Yeah,
it's
absolutely.
It's a huge systemic inequity in the education system. Even if you think about even older problems, one of the biggest inequities with education is that depending on where you live, you get access to such and such teachers, budgets, right. People buy houses to be in a neighborhood where they get to the best schools,
absolutely.
Right? These are the kinds of things that can be reimagined from a learning standpoint. You know, I know we're talking about adult learning here, but even from childhood education standpoint, we've been talking a lot about, well, hey, now I can hire talent anywhere in the country. This really unlocks doors to talent I couldn't access before. Well,
right.
Guess what? The same thing is true for our children, and the quality of education they get is
absolutely.
There's a possibility out here breaking down this inequitable system.
You know, it's really too bad that it took COVID for schools to finally act on an issue that's been around now for at least 20 years.
And I guess that makes me think about, a question for you is, when you think about everyday modern learning and just, you know, what kinds of assumptions do you think we've made around learning, and how do you think those are changing? Like, how do you think people are getting advice today or going after learning just from an everyday example standpoint?
I think the assumption that we've had for a very, very long time, whether it's in education K-12 or whether it's just education in general from a whole host of different topics, is that everybody learns the same way. And we've had this old model of teaching or trying to educate people in a certain way, and it's and they put it in a box. And what we found is that most people don't learn that way, or a lot of them don't.
We're primed to think that everyone is just like us.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
you know, we always like if I say that, oh, I'm heavier on the book learning, then I'm gonna just keep handing everybody a book, right? And
right.
That's a problem. It's like, we need to move out. Whenever you're designing for an audience, you can't be self-centered about that, because it's not about you,
right?
It's about them. And when you think about them, there's a variety. And so I think it's really important for us to realize that. And I think you're making some excellent points there around, many people are visual learners, and probably all of us are, right? Like, all of these siloed dimensions we often name, most of the time everybody's a collection of all of them, right? Like, it's not like, you're kind of on a spectrum.
Because of, you know, the work that I and others on our team do, we're learning that more and more people want to learn visually rather than be fed information, you know, written information, and try to decipher it from there. Crystal, it was a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you so much for spending the time and just hanging out with me and answering some questions and talking about modern ways of learning. Really appreciate it.
Same. Thank you so much, Daryl. I mean, this is a very exciting time. This is a very exciting time to be in this modern learning space. So thanks for having the conversation.
Very exciting time. Thank you so much. Crystal, if folks want to learn more information about you and your organization and what you do, how can they get in touch with you?
First and foremost, go check out our website, www.learningclusterdesign.com. There's only one Crystal Kadakia in the world, so you can find me on LinkedIn. You can email me at crystal@learningclusterdesign.com, and I'm happy to share everything about LCD with you. So anyone who's interested, please feel free to reach out.